4 weeks later, 20-year-old university student Barbara Leach was murdered in the early hours on her way home from a pub in Bradford. She was hit over the head with a hammer and stabbed. Like Josephine Whittaker, she had no link to prostitution and was murdered nowhere near a red light district.
A house in Ashgrove was only 150 yards round the corner, yet Barbara chose to leave her friends and walk on alone in the dark. Somewhere along the way, she met the man they call the Yorkshire Ripper.
I don't like to think of what I'm losing. No, nothing can compensate us for the loss of Barbara.
The Ripper, in the tape-recorded message, had warned that he would strike again, possibly in September or October. Were you prepared for this?
Well, of course, we can't cater for the killing of the odd female at any time.
What's worrying the police is that despite the Ripper's last warning, he was still able to strike again. The truth is, they couldn't do much to stop him. Or even with his voice on tape, his handwriting, and the evidence of 12 murders, they still don't know who he is. All that's left to them is optimism and persistence.
After the murder of Barbara Leach, the police acknowledged that all women were at risk, not just those involved in prostitution. But this didn't change the direction of the investigation.